Welcome, I'm Michael Leemans and I'm a PhD at Eindhoven University of Technology. In this video, we will discuss the discovery of frequent episodes in event logs. We will show you what episodes are, the basics of how we discover them, and we will show you how to discover them in PROM, the Process Mining Toolkit. Consider an event log, a multi-set of traces we know little about. Our goal is to gain insight into the recorded behavior. So, we turn to process mining to analyze the data in the event log. In traditional process discovery, we would mine an end-to-end process model that tries to explain all the observed behavior. However, in practice, these end-to-end process models are often rather complicated and provide little insight. Therefore, we turn to episode discovery, which tries to explain the most frequent behavior in a set of episodes. So, what is an episode? An episode is a partial order over activities. We denote activities as nodes in a graph and depict the partial order between activities with edges. In this example, activity C only occurs after an activity A and B have occurred. After C, another activity A and D occurs. Now, how do we discover episodes from an event log? The basic idea is to construct partial orders and check if they occur in traces in an event log. Take for example this episode and the first trace shown here. To check if an episode occurs in a trace, we relate episode nodes to parts of a trace. In this first example, the first node B is related to the first B in the trace. We continue doing this for the other nodes in the episode as well. The first A in the episode is related to the first A in the trace. The C's are related, and the second A is related to the second A in the trace. And also the D's are matched. Hence, for this first trace, we conclude that this episode occurs in this trace. The same holds for the second trace shown here. Now, what about this third trace? Again, we start by relating nodes to parts of the trace. The first A is matched. However, when we try to relate the D, we encounter that it occurs before a C occurred, violating the partial order of the episode. Hence, we already conclude that this episode does not occur in this trace. For the sake of this example, we continue. Ignoring the D for now, we conclude that a C occurs in the right order with respect to the first A. Next, the E encountered in the trace is not part of the episode, so we ignore it. And the second A is related just as before. Note that we did not find a witness for node B in this trace. This is a second violation of occurrence. Hence, this episode does not occur in the third trace. In the end, we only report frequent episodes, that is, the episodes that occur in the majority of the traces in the event log. Now we will show you how to discover episodes in PROM using a real-life event log from an application process for personal loan. This event log is publicly available as the BPI Challenge Log of 2012. Note that we assume no prior knowledge about this event log. The first question we want to answer is, what are the most frequent control flow patterns? And the second question is, what are the most frequent flow work between persons? Let's start with the first question. We have already loaded the event log into PROM. Click the action button to use this event log. Now we have to find the episode miner plugin. Use the search bar to search for episodes. Now we have two variants of the episode miner. Select the top variant. This will give a configuration dialog before discovery. Now click Start. This is the first configuration dialog and we'll explain the settings briefly. The first settings are log related. We can select the activity client to be used for labeling the nodes and set how local the resulting episode should be. Locality refers to how far apart the mapped activities occur in traces. The second set of settings deal with the episodes. You can set the frequency threshold, indicating the fraction of traces in which an episode must occur before it's considered frequent. And you can set how big the episode should be in terms of the number of nodes and edges. The third set of settings deal with episode rule discovery. If enabled, it will generate predicting rules that indicate if a particular partial order has been observed, how the trace is likely to be completed. For now, leave the settings at the default values and click Next. In this dialog, you can set the activities to be used in discovering episodes. The list indicates the activities in EventLog selected to be included in Discovery. And by using the slider, one can filter out infrequent activities. Click Finish to start Discovery. The result is a list of frequent episodes discovered. Let's look at one such episode. We can see the frequency of the episode in the top left corner. And the graph depicts the discovered partial order. In this case, a submitted activity is followed by a partially submitted and a pre-accepted activity in that order. This partial order is one of the answers to our first analysis question. We have one analysis question remaining, discovering the flow of work between persons. Again, we will be using the configuration dialog, so select the top variant and click Start. In the first dialog, we will change the event classifiers and the upper bound on the in-trace distance. We want to use resources instead of activities on our episode nodes and are also interested in less local patterns. For now, a distance of 50 will do. In addition, we also lower the frequency threshold. .25 will do. Now, click Next. In the second dialog, we see the values to be used on the episode nodes. Note that the list now displays resource IDs instead of activities. Click Finish to start Discovery. The result is again a list of discovered episodes, in this case illustrating the flow of work between persons or resources. Note that its list is sorted on frequency. Let's zoom in to the top right results. First, note that the pattern containing only resources 112 has a frequency of a 1. This implies that resource 112 is present in all traces. In the right result, we see that the flow of work is passed from resource 112 to tasks without a recorded resource. The absence of resources indicated by the empty nodes and could signify automated tasks. These observations are part of the answer to our second analysis question. This concludes our analysis, and we have shown how to answer these questions using episode discovery. Now you know what episodes are and how to discover them using the Process Mining Toolkit. Thank you for watching and hope to see you again soon.